Why are some people naturally so strong? Imagine walking into a gym and seeing a lean, average-looking guy outlifting massive bodybuilders. No steroids, no cheating, just raw power. Meet Anatoly, an internet sensation who's shocked millions with his freakish strength. Despite weighing only around 78 kilograms, or 172 pounds, he's deadlifted over 290 kilograms, or 639 pounds. How is that possible? Is it lucky DNA, secret superhuman genes, or something anyone can train for? In this video, we're breaking down the science behind natural strength, and whether you can unlock it yourself. Genetics, your strength blueprint. Let's start at the core genetics. Studies on twins and families show that 30 to 80% of your athletic ability is determined by genes. That includes how easily you gain strength, how fast you recover, and how powerful your muscles can become. Take muscle fibers, for instance. You've got slow twitch fibers built for endurance, fast twitch fibers built for speed and power. The more fast twitch fibers you're born with, the better your chances at explosive strength. Now meet the ACTN3 gene, nicknamed the sprint gene. If you have a working copy called 577RR, your muscles produce more of a protein vital for fast twitch fibers. Most elite sprinters and powerlifters have this version. On the other hand, the 577XX variant, more common in endurance athletes. And then there's the ACE gene. One version helps your body become more power-oriented, the other more endurance-focused. But it's not just fiber type. Tendon insertions also matter. If your bicep tendon attaches lower on the forearm, your leverage improves, giving you more curl strength without bigger muscles. In short, genetics doesn't just shape your looks. It builds the foundation for your mechanics, muscle potential, and raw output. Now let's talk about rare cases, people who literally have super strength genes. Meet the Belgian blue bull. It looks photoshopped, muscles stacked on muscles. Why? A mutation in the myostatin gene, or MSTN? Myostatin is like a muscle growth brake. Knock it out and muscles grow without limits. Some humans are born with this mutation too. In 2004, a German toddler stunned doctors. He had almost no body fat and massive muscle tone, and he wasn't even 5 years old. Genetic tests showed he had a double mutation in his myostatin gene. Another US child, known as the world's strongest toddler, could lift adult weights due to a similar mutation affecting myostatin receptors. While rare, these cases reveal a lot. Even small tweaks in genetic signals can massively increase muscle size and strength. And understanding them could lead to treatments for muscle diseases. But don't worry. You don't need a rare mutation to become strong. Most elite lifters don't have them. They rely on what we'll explore next. Nervous system, the hidden strength engine. Muscles are just the hardware, but the real secret weapon, the software, your nervous system. Even if two people have the same muscle size, the one with better neuromuscular efficiency can lift more. That's because their brain sends faster, more powerful signals to activate more muscle fibers at once. Think of it this way: your brain is the coach, your nerves are the messengers, your muscles are the team. A great coach with fast messengers gets the best performance. This is why elite athletes often have insane vertical jumps, a key test of neural efficiency. A 30-plus inch vertical jump usually signals explosive neural output. And guess what? This ability is part genetic and part trainable. Many strength gains in the first 4 to 6 weeks of training come not from muscle growth, but from better nerve signaling. So, Anatoly? He probably has superb neuromuscular wiring, from both nature and intense training. Can you train like the naturally strong? Now for the best part, can you train to be strong, even without gifted genes? Yes. Even if you don't have perfect genes, the right training can unlock incredible progress. Start with heavy compound lifts like squats, deadlifts, and bench presses. Incorporate progressive overload by consistently increasing weight or reps. Add neuromuscular drills, which include explosive movements and low-rep heavy sets. And remember, recovery is crucial. Muscle growth happens during rest, not training. And don't underestimate consistency. Over 12 months, consistent training can take you from weak to warrior. Studies show that environmental factors like training and diet account for up to 70% of your strength progress. Yes, genetics loads the gun, but training pulls the trigger. Even without the ACTN3 gene, you might only be 2-3% behind. And that's a gap you can close with smarter programming and effort. So, why are some people naturally strong? It's not magic, it's genetics plus nervous system plus training plus time. Anatoly may have a high percentage of fast twitch fibers, great muscle insertions for leverage, a nervous system firing at full power, and years of smart, consistent training. But here's the takeaway. Even if you're not built like Anatoly, you can build your best strength version. Focus on smart strength programs, heavy low rep sets for neural drive, enough food and recovery, and consistency. The true game changer. What do you think matters most in strength, genetics or training? Drop your opinion in the comments. Share your story. Are you naturally strong, or did you build it over time? If you like this breakdown, hit like, subscribe, and ring the bell for more science-based fitness videos. Stay strong, stay curious. See you next time on DeepBrain.